No. No. I can't do this anymore. I can't. But I must. I must. Only lead your father, Lord, out of this. As in the dream, I've climbed mountain or there. For you've called me. You've chosen me. I'll do this. I'll master this. For I am La Quena. I am your messenger. The God's chosen one. With this water, I purify myself. From today on, I'm holy and pure in the eyes of God, my Lord, my Father, my Savior. From today on, I'm a new person, and I'll do what? I'll purify my people as I have been purified. So begins the history of the Acholi. I will lead my people to the Holy Land. I'll lead my people to the Promised Land. I'll lead them, Lord, my chosen ones, from suppression to liberty. I'll deliver every boy and every girl from the hands of the devils in the south into your light, my Lord. So, we again become strong. The spirits stir around me. I can hear them. They whisper over here. Kill no people. Kill only bad people. Kill no people. Kill only bad people. I swear to you, Lord, I can hear them. And I know that from today on, we shall always live by your commandments. And I swear to you, Lord, that here and now, in this very place, on this very rock, in Odea, begins a new story. From my very home here, I shall lead this crusade. I'll kill no people. I'll only kill bad people. For I am the anointed one. I am La Quena. And I am Joseph Carr. What is ahead? Did you know that you can read a man's character by looking at the shape of his head? Yes, you can know what sort of a person he is. For example, a bump here at the front means that he is courageous. A dent there in the side means that he is honest. But a note there at the back means that he is deceptive and not to be trusted. You can even tell a man's future by looking at the shape of his head. Yes, close your eyes. Close them tight. Now, there. Do you see me glowing there at the back of your eyelids? Don't you see me there? In the darkness, there. That's where I live. That's where I stay. Do you see me there, with my heart reading your head? That is an example of a bad head. I wanted to bring you one, so that you get to know how one looks like. He wanted to smuggle a radio into the camp, so that he could feed his head with bad thoughts. God ordered me to punish him, and I followed God's orders, just like a good servant does. Now, a good head, a head filled with good thoughts, will continue speaking and making noise and shouting even after it is cut off. Yes, it is in the Bible. But this one doesn't say much, does it?